Hello everyone, this is Ankita Rani and in this video I will continue with the explaining of different types of business letter. So my next kind of business letter is complaint letter. So as you all can guess by looking at the name of this complaint letter, so you all can guess that okay, through this letter we can complain. So actually let me tell you that a complaint letter can be, it is a type of business letter. It can be written by a businessman or any individual. Say like for example, you can say any student or any individual. A complaint letter can be written by a businessman or any individual. So why there is a need for writing a complaint letter? So actually we can write complaint letter when we have purchased some goods or products, or we have got some services which is not up to the mark, which is defective one. So we can write a complaint letter regarding the product or services. Got you? So through this way we can write a complaint letter. Actually the basic mode of writing a complaint letter is to asking for the compensation, right? Suppose that, let me tell you through, let me explain through the example. Suppose that if you have bought a mobile phone, right? And that mobile phone turns out to be a defective one. It's not working properly. You have anywhere you have purchased it from store or online services, then what you can do, you can write a complaint letter so that you can get compensation. Either you can get your money back or you can get some the new handset, because we all have paid money for it, so we want that compensation. It's a human behavior, it's a very common thing. So the basic motto of writing complaint letter is to let the owner know, let the manufacturer know that what is, let the seller know that what is the defect that it is coming in the product, right? And so that you can get money back or replacement, compensation. So the basic motto of writing a complaint letter, actually I've written in a explanation, a complaint letter asks for the compensation for defective or damaged goods or for inadequate or delayed services, right? The words and the tone chosen to use in a letter complaining to a business may be the deciding factor on whether your complaint is satisfied. Be direct but tactful and always use a professional tone if we want the company to take action in regard to the letter. Okay, let me actually tell you in a nutshell that suppose that if you ever felt like writing a complaint letter, so always be direct. Whatever the problem is coming in your product, explain that thing thoroughly, and you should be direct and always be tactful. It doesn't mean that you are annoyed with their services, then you are free to use any kind of disrespectful wrong words for them, because we need to be professional all the time. Right, we need to be professional, so because it's a formal letter, definitely. So and that the way through in which you write your letter will decide that whether they will consider your complaint letter or not. So always be direct and tactful, and whatever problem is coming in your product, explain them properly. And always use a professional tone, never ever abuse them. You are free to show your disappointment, anger in a very tactful manner. Definitely it's a matter of disappointment that you have paid for something and you haven't got the fresh product. So definitely it's a human nature, but you need to be very professional while explaining all the things, while expressing your disappointment. So I think you have got something, because complaint letter is a very sounds very common, and definitely it's about complaining. So I have told you what to write in a complaint letter, and moving to the next category of business letter. Okay, let me tell you the next kind of business letter is adjustment letter. As you all can see, So let me just read it out. An adjustment letter is normally sent in response to a claim or complaint. If the adjustment is in the customer's favor, begin the letter with that news. If not, keep your tone factual and let the customer know that you understand the complaint. Again, in the it is different. It is one of the kind of a business letter and adjustment letter. What happens in an adjustment letter? Who writes the adjustment letter? You have to explain all the things in while explaining this question. Okay, adjustment letter is a response, is a reply of a complaint letter. Suppose that if you have written any complaint letter, so you will get a adjustment letter. Right, in response to a complaint letter. Actually, adjustment letter is a procedure through which the businessman actually want to connect with the customer, because definitely what happens, what I have already told you, that it's a reply that you have complained regarding the product which they have, manufactured or they have sold. So what happens, just after receiving your complaint letter, they try to adjust the gap, because already a gap has been created. So next time you won't prefer to buy that brand product. You will try to skip that brand because your experience was not so good. So it's kind of they want to adjust. They want to fill the gap. They want to create the bonding between customer and seller, because in every business customer is of great value. Okay, so they write adjustment letter. It is by the side of the seller or manufacturer, you can say. So already I have written, an adjustment letter is normally sent in response to a claim or complaint. So suppose that in complaint letter you have asked for the compensation. So if possible, and you have written in a very professional tone, you have written directly, tactfully, you have shown your disappointment, so they have considered your complaint letter and they are replying you through adjustment letter that they will actually try to apologize for the services or products which have been provided to you, right? And they will give the compensation if possible, and if not possible, they will let you know, right, that they understand the complaint, what I have already written. If the adjustment is in the customer's favor, begin the letter with that news. If not, keep your tone factual and let the customer know that you understand the complaint. Actually, suppose that if you will join a company and if you will ever get a chance to write an adjustment letter, so you can follow this step, right? That time you will act as a from the seller sides or from the manufacturer side. So you need to know about both aspect, complaint letter and adjustment letter too, because it's one of the type of the business letter. So I've written the explanation. So I hope you have got the concept of complaint letter and adjustment letter. In my next video I will cover the other type of business letter. Till then, bye, and thanks for watching my video.